Quality Function Deployment, or QFD, helps you to direct your attention to those things that matter the most for the client when designing or redesigning any kind of product or service for the client. That could be software, that could be a theme park, and that could be a car. It does not matter. In our case, many years back, before we were even certified as Lean Six Sigma professionals, at the university that we teach, we came to the conclusion that our undergraduate business administration degree needs to be redesigned, because for years it had remained as it was, and it was time for a redesign. At that time, the process was a huge mess. You have all these parties, professors, researchers, normal lecturers, IT people, support staff, management, all of them wanting to somehow control this process. No one really knew exactly what we should focus on to give the customer, the potential student, the most value for his or her money. So the process was very messy. Had we known about QFD, the process would have been much more lean, efficient, and effective. So in this exercise, we're going to use that hypothetical example of designing a undergraduate business administration degree with the help of the QFD tool. QFD actually is quite a broad concept. It really is. But at the absolute core of it is this, the so-called house of quality. Now, why is this called the house of quality? Well, I guess it kind of looks like a house. It doesn't look like my house, but it doesn't matter. It looks like a house nevertheless. Now, if you browse various sources, books or internet, doesn't matter, and you look for the house of quality, you will notice something. Each source uses a variation of this house of quality that looks slightly different from the other one. The reason is actually quite simple. There is no universal definition of how a house of quality should actually look like, but there is a core definition, and we use that core definition. So our house of quality contains all the elements that should be there, but maybe in another source you will find that there's an extra element there, or an element that we use maybe not there. Does not matter. This contains all the important stuff. By the way, if you purchase this course, then attached to this video is a resource, a file that basically contains this. This is an empty house of quality that you can later use for your own studies or for your own work. So you can download this empty template as well if you have purchased this course. It is attached to the video. Also, an exercise is attached to this video, so please also download that. Let's go back to our house of quality. On the left side, we see the so-called voice of customer. That is what the customer, the potential student, says he or she wants. The program should be international, affordable, the degree should be respectable, the program should be flexible, a realistic pass chance, and the program should be cool, all right? Just fictional answers. Furthermore, we ask this hypothetical customer to give some kind of weight to these things that he or she actually wants. And we use 1, 3, and 5 as weights. 5 being very important, 1 being not so important, and 3 being something in the middle. Why 1, 3, and 5? Why not 1 to 10? Well, it's a personal choice. You can deviate from that as long as you give higher scores to things that are more important. It does not really interfere with the end result all that much. We use 1, 3, and 5. On top, we see the factors that we control. Now, what do we control? We control, for instance, the number of lectures, the number of tutorials, the number of research articles that our professors publish per year, or the approximation of that, the number of test moments, so how often can you do an exam, the number of online lectures, so the lectures that are available online on top of being also available physical, the number of foreign partners. These are foreign universities that we partner up with, and our students, for instance, can do an exchange program with them. The number of professors from the business world that maybe bring with them all kinds of interesting stories and cool stories that help to make, give the program a little bit spice, a little bit practical flavor. The number of elective courses, of course, we control, and the study cost is also something that we control. We also control a lot more, but we cut it off at this point because this is just meant to be an example. Now here in the middle part, you see all kinds of symbols scattered through. Now these symbols, they come actually from this part. So we see that we use the symbol, the cross, to indicate a strong relationship, and it has a numerical value attached to it, namely 10. We use the asterisk to indicate a medium relationship, and it has also a numerical value attached to it, namely 5. And if we don't use any symbol, if we leave it blank, then there is no relationship, or the relationship is very weak, and it has a numerical value of 0. Again, 0, 5, and 10, these are just values that work for us. If rather you would use 1, 2, and 3, that is also okay. It won't really interfere with the end result all that much, so feel free to deviate if that is what you feel better with. Now, as far as the choice for these symbols, you actually do this in a group, a multidisciplinary group, not by yourself. So you invite a bunch of stakeholders, and then together you're going to brainstorm about the following. So for instance, should we put here a symbol or not? And in our fictional example, we put there a symbol. And to be more precise, we put there a cross, which indicates, just as we just showed you, a strong relationship. What does that mean? There's a strong relationship between this factor that we control, namely the number of foreign partner universities, and this voice of customer element, namely that they want to have the program to be nice and international. Of course, the more foreign partner universities you have, the more international experience you can potentially offer the customer. So that's why it has a very strong positive relationship there. Why is there no symbol here? Because there is no relationship, or a very weak relationship, between the number of test moments and the voice of customer that says, I want the program to be nice and international. That's why this part is empty. Okay, so I assume the logic there of these symbols and what you fill in when is now clear. I'm not going to waste your time by going through all of them. Please take into consideration that a level of subjectiveness is always there, okay? But you try to minimize the subjectiveness as much as possible by working in a multidisciplinary group, which hopefully prevents any kind of bias there, okay? But please realize, if someone else fills this in, there might be a slight deviation from what you fill in. What we do subsequently is we actually continue to these importance factors, which you see over here. Now let's have a look at one of these values. For instance, this value over here, 65. How do we arrive there at this value of 65? Well, we look at the symbols that you see in this column, and that is this one and this one. This one indicates a value of 10. And this one indicates a value of 5. You can see it basically here. Furthermore, we see here the weights. So we multiply the weights by the numerical value of these symbols. So we have 5 times 10, that would be this part, and we have 3 times 5, because this value is valued at 5. So 3 times 5 and 5 times 10. This is 50, and this is 15, and together they are 65, okay? So together they are 65, and that explains basically why you have this value here. The same principle also counts for the other values. I'm not going to waste your time there. I'm sure the principle is now clear. Now, how do we interpret these values? Well, as follows. If we see here a very low value, for instance 5, that means that the factor that is attached to this value, namely the number of electives, does not have a very, very, very strong, you know, role in achieving customer satisfaction. So in satisfying this voice of customer, namely what the customer wants, this factor here is not a very important one. But this one here that has a very high value, namely the number of foreign partners, has a very, very, very strong effect on satisfying the voice of customer. So basically, the values that you see in this row indicate how strongly you should focus on those factors that you control. This is a very, very, very useful thing. Looking back at the problems that we faced when we wanted to redesign our program, I only wish that at that time we were aware of this tool and could utilize it, because it really helps you to focus your attention and see which factor should I focus on the most in order to satisfy the customer's demands. Now in this column, we provide information about our main competitor or our main competitors as an average. And we do it like that. If the competitor is not doing such a great job on that element, we give a score of 1, which indicates that the performance is quite bad. If their performance is okay, we give them 3. And if their performance is very good or excellent, we give them a score of 5. Again, 1, 3, and 5 is our personal choice. If rather you would like to do 1, 2, and 3, that is also fine, as long as it's clear to you and those working with you what you actually mean with these various values, and they should of course be in a certain order. In this particular case, for instance, we gave a score hypothetically of 1 in terms of the affordability when we look at our competitors. So in this hypothetical example, our main competitors have very, very bad affordability. In other words, their degrees are very, very expensive. But for instance, in terms of flexibility, we give them a score of 5. So our main competitors or main competitor is doing an excellent job in providing a flexible business administration program to undergraduate students. Now, why do I need that information about competitors? Because it's an extra support in terms of information. For instance, if I decide that I want to focus on the number of online lectures that I provide. Why? Because it has a high score and it helps me to achieve the customer's wishes a lot. So it impacts them a lot. And I wish to focus on that. Then I look up which elements are attached to that. And that would be this. And that would be this one. Okay, and then I look at how my competitors are doing in that area, and then I see that they're doing actually a great job. So for me, it's a sign that if I want to focus on that, I better do it extremely well, because if I want to compete with these people, they are doing a great job, and I need to do an exceptionally great job if I wish to compete. It would be another story if they would be doing a poor job. Then I only need to direct a little bit of my resources there, and I can already outperform them. So it's an extra piece of information there that you can use. Now, last but not least, we look at the roof of this house of quality, where we indicate basically the relationship between the factors that we control. For instance, the relationship between study cost and the number of online lectures. And we indicate if that relationship is highly positive, positive, negative, or highly negative. And we use these symbols basically to indicate that. Okay, what does positive mean? Positive means that when one factor goes up, the other one is also likely to go up. Negative means that when one factor goes up, the other one is likely to go down. If the relationship is not really there, if it's weak, then we don't use any symbol at all. So we only use a symbol if, you know, it's profound positive or highly positive or profound negative or highly negative. And otherwise, we don't use a symbol at all. Now, we wanted to know the relationship between online lectures and study cost, okay? Now, is there a relationship? Yes, I think so, because from experience, I can tell you that when you have more online lectures, that although it costs some money to record them, over the long term, you know, the cost that you incur will go down because you need less professors. Many of the questions can be just answered by looking at a video. So overall, although there are some costs in the beginning, over the long term, there is a mild, relationship there that is negative. So there is a negative relationship there. More online lectures brings down the study cost over the long term a little bit, not that much. So we use for that this symbol. So we use for that this symbol, and this circle that does not have anything filled in. Now, where do we fill in that information? You have to ask yourself where these two factors, online lectures and study cost, actually meet, and that is where they intersect each other. And that would be actually at this point, you see, because that is where both of them meet. So this part, this is where you fill in this circle, as simple as that, okay? And then you make a choice per part here, whether it should be a circle or a triangle pointing up or a triangle pointing down or whatever. And if there's no real relationship there, it's not strong or even just medium, then leave it blank. When is this handy? This is handy later along if you wish to, you know, shift your focus, for instance, from this to this or from this to this, then this roof helps you to realize that, hey, if I change this focus and I focus from, you know, one factor to another factor, how will they relate? Okay, this is basically the end. I hope you realize the usefulness of this, because without this, you don't know what to focus on in order to serve the customer. I only wish we had this tool at our disposal. Please make use of this free template that we made available for those who purchase the course. It is attached to this video. And also don't forget to download the exercises also attached to this video. I hope this tool is going to serve you well.